I've always done art my whole life, like when I was a little kid. It wasn't necessarily good when I first started, but I loved it, so I took to it and I got better quick. But that's what got me into it. That was my original love. Basically, when I was younger, I had a babysitter who was a family friend. He was a college student. He did a lot of illustrations and drawings for the newspaper. That's what he did. When my parents used to drop me off at his family's house to watch us, he'd be also working on his project. So my sisters, they would sit there and watch TV while we were over there, but me, I was so amazed with what he was doing, I'd sit there and just watch him draw. Eventually, he told my parents that like when he'd work on his stuff, I'd just sit there and watch him. I'm really into art, so they should start getting me into different programs. Then when I was in high school, I started hanging out with a lot of kids who did graffiti and stuff like that. And that was my second love. This is the lowest it's gonna go for any one point. Yeah, right about there. Feel free to write in the zone if you want. Lettering is my weakness. The Dolphins came to me and approached me, and they had an idea for an activation. They were pairing up with Bud Light. They would do a portrait of 1 to 4 of their super fans. So they basically selected the gentleman in the center. His name's Fred. I met with Fred, talked to him, got to know him, and he brought his friends, which is Malcolm and Moose.
I mean, I've seen Nate's work all throughout Wynwood and throughout the world, really. So just to be here, you know, I don't know, I'm kind of short on words, man. It's pretty exciting for me.
The minute I looked at them, I looked at Serge and I nodded my head. I was like, these are our people, you know? You always get like people portraying Miami from like an outsider's point of view, you know what I mean? And with this mural, this is like the heart and soul I'm trying to at least capture. Luckily, I've had the opportunity to do a lot of work out of state, especially within the last year. I've done 2 projects in Iowa. I just came off a project that I did in South Korea, which was amazing. So I think that's what I'm looking towards, like opportunities to really represent Miami, South Florida, the 305, outside of the state. What I've seen since Basel started getting popular is a change of values and a change of ideals. You know, like in the beginning, what got me into street art and doing murals and things like that is because I realized there was so much more opportunities to do it because of Art Basel and because of Wynwood and the rise of Wynwood and people doing street art and doing murals over there. The current state of arts here in Miami, what I like about it is that, as I said before, there's opportunities to do a lot of things. We have places like, for example, the Perez Museum, where a lot of people, they'll complain about the Perez saying they don't represent local artists, but if you really paid attention, they do have local artists on the roster. You know, the fact that Wynwood Walls might feature a whole bunch of artists out of town, there's still 1 or 2 Miami artists, and I think that it can only get better. What people don't realize is they complain about these big artists that come here and everyone focuses on them, but when they leave, then the focus comes back to us, and we still grow our careers based off of that and get attention based off of that. Right now we're in Little Haiti, we're on the 62nd Street corridor, and the mural behind me is called Seeing and Believing Wisdom. The animals usually are a metaphor for something greater, a greater idea. So the idea of the owl is the idea of knowledge and wisdom. One person has the owl on their shoulder, which represents them believing wisdom. The other person has it on their head, or the mask on their head, that represents seeing wisdom. It got me thinking about a conversation I had last time I painted in this area, and that's that this area of Little Haiti is really starting to experience a gentrification. There's a lot of businesses that are coming in, buying out big parcels of land. And from what I understand, they have plans to change basically the whole nature of this district. So So it made me think of the idea of wisdom. Like, it's really good to pour money into communities, but when you develop the communities, I think that there should be a way of doing it that's wise, where you take the people who really make that community what it is and really give it its character, to put them at a seat at the table. I think the reason why art affects culture so much is because it's one of those things that's unspoken. I think that it's a really easy way to push culture. It's the face of culture. But when you think of the arts, especially visual arts, all these things, they tap into something that's in you that's innate, that you can't even really put your finger on, but it still is touching that button and pressing that button in all of us. Because of that quality of it, it's used to create change. It's used to create value, whether it's perceived value or actual value.